everyone. I am Swati Rai Singh, working as an assistant professor in R.C. Patel Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, Shirpur, Dhule. I am from Quality Assurance Department, and my week 4 video topic is Carbon Footprint for Packaging. These are the details of my week 1 and week 2 videos. The 1 week video topic is Green and Sustainable Pharmacy, and I have recorded 12 likes and 36 number of views for that video. And week 2 video topic is Environmental Sustainability in Pharmaceutical Packaging, and for that video I have recorded 5 likes and 15 number of views. Video outcomes. So after learning to this video, student will understand about uses of packaging materials and different categories of packaging. Also they will aware about different ISO standards in the packaging industry. Then they will understand about packaging carbon footprint. Also student will understand about sustainable packaging and what are the different benefits about green packaging. So starting from introduction, so packaging perform various functions. It protect and promote product, make distribution and use easier, deliver important information, and can potentially minimize the environmental impact of the product. Important ISO standard in the packaging industry. So ISO standards are the internationally recognized specifications for product, services and systems. There are several overarching ISO standards which are important in the packaging industry, such as ISO 9001 for packaging manufacturer, and this ISO standard gives a clear signal to customer that you are able to make ISO quality packaging. ISO 14001 demonstrate a company's commitment to the environment. So these flowchart represent different ISO standards for the packaging, like ISO 18601, also ISO 18603, etc. So packaging has positive and negative impact on the environment. What are the positive and negative impact? So the negative impact include resources which are used and effect of packaging related waste and emissions. These are the negative impact of packaging. Also it have some positive impact, and these are that packaging consumer good facilitate their distribution and thus make it possible to obtain goods otherwise not accessible. Next one is the packaging carbon footprints. What are the carbon footprints for packaging? So carbon footprint of a packaging system is the total amount of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases like methane emitted over the life cycle of that product or service. Life cycle of that product means the different manufacturing procedure for that packaging material expressed as a kilogram of carbon dioxide equivalent. This include all greenhouse gases generated in the manufacture of the raw material, also fabrication of the packaging system, then transport of different packaging materials and finished systems. This carbon footprint is often included in the analysis of the larger product system that uses the packaging. So this diagram represent packaging linked to carbon pollution. So this diagram represent different percentage of carbon footprint for packaging. Now here one example for carbon footprint calculation. So it is a simple basic calculation. Here I give the example for consumption of different fuel like petrol, gasoline, diesel, oil, etc. And by using that fuel, how much CO2 emitted per unit. This is the personal carbon footprint. Now next, what are the different packaging materials? So today, a wide range of materials are used for packaging applications, including metal, glass, wood, paper or pulp based materials, plastic, ceramics or also a combination of more than one material as a composite. They are applied in three broad categories of packaging. These are primary packaging, secondary packaging and tertiary packaging. So primary packaging, which create same unit and is normally in contact with the goods, while secondary packaging such as cardboard boxes then plastic containers to carry quantities of primary packaged good. And third one is the tertiary packaging, or it is also called as transport packaging, that is used to assist transport of large quantities of goods. Now up till we study about the packaging materials, then carbon footprint for packaging. Now to overcome that carbon footprint, the alternate is green packaging. So what is mean by green packaging? So green packaging, which is also called as sustainable packaging, uses materials and the manufacturing technique to diminish energy used and reduce the harmful impact of packaging on the environment. So green packaging solutions often include biodegradable and different recyclable materials in preference to material like plastic and styrofoam. And this green manufacturing process take step to reduce their power output, and also it reduces the number of greenhouse emissions they produced. So eco-friendly packaging goes by a few other names such as sustainable packaging, green packaging and environmentally friendly packaging. To be eco-friendly packaging can be biodegradable, then recyclable, reusable, non-toxic, made from recycled product, based in biomass or natural product, or manufactured through low impact means. Next one is the examples of sustainable packaging. So packaging that include renewable resource. First example here, packaging that include renewable resources. Here the example of such type of renewable resource is cellulose. For example, which derive from wood pulp is an attractive alternative to petroleum derived polymers. Also another example of this renewable resource is starch based biomaterial. Then second example of sustainable packaging is packaging with additives. Here packaging additives primarily biodegradable, oxodegradable and photodegradable materials, which help the packaging biodegrade faster and reduce the accumulation of packaging waste. Another some examples of sustainable packaging are recyclable materials. So in that, these include familiar materials such as cardboard, plastic and metals. Then another example, compostable material. These include the material like the compostable molded fiber bowl that some fast casual restaurants now offer their patrons. Then another example, bubble wrap. This is widely used as a packaging material. Here environmentally friendly alternatives include bubble wrap, made from recycled polyethylene and bubble wrap, which is completely degradable. What are the main features of sustainable packaging? So these are: produces little to no environmental waste, it made from reusable or biodegradable packaging materials, then it is safe for people and the environment. Benefit of using green packaging. So sustainable packaging offer a wide array of benefits for both consumer as well as for the environment. So first benefit: diminished reliance on fossil fuel. So green packaging strives to use as little fossil fuel energy as possible to reduce the carbon footprint of packaging manufacturing. Second benefit: it reduced use of natural resource. By designing minimal packaging, green packaging manufacturers help to reduce the consumption of natural resources, and this reduction help ensure resource will remain on our planet for our future generations. Increased use of recycled product. Here, the more we can recycle post-consumer material, less energy and fewer resources we waste on creating all new packaging. So recycled products are less water and less energy than their brand new cousins. More energy efficient manufacturing method. Instead of relying on fossil fuel, green packaging strives to use alternative power such as wind or solar energy. And next, increased use of renewable resource. So instead of using paper derived from cutting down trees, we used renewable resources. Thank you.